Hi friends, today let us learn learning strategy or learning paradigms. So these are related to environment, how the environment would be. Within that environment, let us play learning rules so that the entire system will be trained based on the learning rules, and this is the environment provided. Let us see the first learning strategy or learning paradigm. As we already know, NN stands for neural networks, here LS stands for learning strategy, and LP stands for learning paradigm. In some textbooks, they are following as learning strategy, and in some textbook, they are following as learning paradigm. So I like to incorporate both of them. Anyhow, this is the supervised learning, and commonly called as learning with a teacher. So this come under the learning paradigm of learning with a teacher. Here a teacher will be there. Let us see how the teacher will give the suggestion to neural network and how it will be. The teacher may have the knowledge of environment, and the environment is not known to the learning system. Now both teacher and learning system are exposed to the training vector. If that is the case, what will happen? For example, let us see, one of the block diagrams is like this. We can draw. This is the environment, and environment is providing information or input data to both teacher and as well as learning system. Teacher knows everything about the environment, and learning system may not, it doesn't know anything about the environment. Simply it is taking the inputs, and in teacher is also taking the inputs. So vector describing the state of the environment is provided to both teacher and the learning system, and finally the teacher will give us desired response as he knows the environment completely, but the learning system gives us only actual response because it is having less knowledge of environment. Otherwise it don't have any knowledge of environment, it is simply taking the inputs. That's it. So finally, we will take the difference of these two, desired response and the actual response. So finally, we will come up with an error, and that error is the basis. Error signal is basis for learning system. So this error signal is keep on changing the weights of the learning system so that the error signal will be minimized, and maybe it is approximately equal to zero. That what we have already done in error correction learning rule. Okay, of course the same rule has been used here. That's the thing. So how the operation will be? So as the teacher knows everything about the system or the environment, so it will produce the desired response, and obviously because of lack of knowledge, the learning system is provided with only actual response, and the difference is the error signal. We have already discussed this. And then how the training will be? The training is performed based on error signal so as to minimize the error, or we are making it to zero. That's what we have to do every time. So whenever this condition is reached, okay, once it was reached, it's zero, then what will happen? If the condition has been reached, then the teacher is separated, and the learning system is, it can run by itself by using environment. It's directly connected to environment, and there is no teacher at all. It's that link was disabled. This form of supervised learning is the error correction learning rule. We have already learned this, okay? And based on error correction learning rule, it has been done. Coming to methods, how it will be minimized means it's a closed loop with environment is outside the closed loop. Actually it's a closed loop, but the environment is not within the closed loop, it should be the outside the closed loop. As a performance measure, the sum of squared errors over training samples defined as the function of free parameters. That means the sum of squared errors has been taken here as the cost function, and we need to minimize the same. The true error surface is the averaged over all input and output examples. So it's an average of these things, maybe the squared errors of each and every point, and that is the true error surface, and we need to minimize the same error. This error is minimized by steepest descent gradient method, and this is a method in mathematics. By using this method, we can keep on minimizing the things and we can make it to zero after some iterations. So we need to run the show, we need to run the same training up to those iterations so that our error will be zero. Otherwise we can satisfy with some limit also. That's what we need to do. Yeah, this is regarding supervised learning or learning with a teacher, and this is one of the, or we can call it a, this is the first learning strategy or first learning paradigm. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please like it. If you want to share with your friends, please share with your friends so that you can share the knowledge with other persons. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please try to subscribe, as this is very encouragement for me to do very good videos like this. And please try to press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload the video. Thank you very much.